matatep at matatag, bansang makabata, batang makabansa. Hello students, and shout out to Grade 10 Bonifacio, Rizal, Agoncillo, and Lapu-Lapu, Batch 2023-2024. Welcome to Grade 10 Science Lesson for 4th Quarter. I am your Grade 10 Science Teacher, Sir Darrell Villorente. In your lower grade science lesson, you have learned about chemical reactions. Back in grade 7, you were introduced to the fascinating worlds of acids and bases. If you can still recall, you may have conducted some experiments involving the use of indicators to show the color changes that occur when these substances are tested. During one of these experiments, you may have observed that acid turned blue litmus paper into red. This is because acids have a low pH and can donate protons to other substances. When litmus paper is dipped in an acidic solution, the paper turns red as the result of the hydrogen ions reacting with the indicator. Similarly, you may have observed that bases turn red litmus paper to blue. This is because bases have a high pH and can accept protons from other substances. When a litmus paper is dipped in a basic solution, just like the soap, the paper turns blue as a result of the hydroxide ions reacting with the indicator. This simple setup is just the beginning of what you will learn about acid and bases as you progress through your studies of chemistry. You will learn about the different strengths of acid and bases, their properties, and how they react in various environments. These concepts are essential for understanding many different fields of science, from medicine to agriculture to environmental science. So as you continue on your journey to the world of chemistry, always remember the basics that you learned back in grade 7. These simple concepts are the foundation for understanding the complex chemical reactions that shape our world. Acid and bases react with each other in a neutralization reaction to form a salt and water. The pH of the resulting solution is neutral, which is pH 7. Chemical reactions can have an impact on the reactivity of metals. For example, as you can see on the picture, metals can undergo oxidation and reduction reaction, which can change their reactivity. But what do we mean by oxidation and reduction? Oxidation is a process where a metal loses electron and becomes more positively charged. This can occur when a metal reacts with an oxidizing agent such as oxygen or an acid. For example, when an iron example of that is a nail, reacts with oxygen in the air. We all know that oxygen comprises almost 20 to 21% of the Earth's atmosphere. As the air, which is the oxygen present in the air, combine with the metal, which is iron, it forms an iron oxide. Iron oxide is a technical term in chemistry, but commonly it is known as RAS or kalawang. So, ibig sabihin, pag nagkaroon ng isang kalawang ang isang metal, ang oxygen na present sa air ay nag-react sa metal na yon. How about, sir, yung mga nababad sa tubig? Since water has a chemical formula of H2O, there is still a presence of oxygen. So the oxygen will react to the metal. So definitely you can see that there is rusting or may kalawang na nabubuo sa isang metal. This reaction weakens the metal and makes it less reactive. So on that simple setup or scenario that you observe every day, meron na pala dong chemical reaction. But what do we mean by reduction? Reduction is a process where a metal gains electrons and becomes more negatively charged particles. So, gains. Tumanggap siya ng electrons. Yung isa ay nag-lose ng electrons. Kaya kapag nag-lose ka ng electrons, kung konti ang iyong electrons, dadami ang iyong protons. Kaya ang iyong charge ay positive. But if you are gaining an electron, so definitely electron is higher or greater than the proton. That makes an object or makes a substance or an element a negatively charged particles. So ibig sabihin mas madami ang electrons compared with the positive. This can occur when a metal reacts with a reducing agent such as hydrogen or a metal with a lower electronegativity. So for oxidation, we have oxygen, and for reduction, we also have here a hydrogen. For example, when a copper is placed in a solution of silver nitrate, a copper, usually, ang ating mga barya ay made up of copper. It will displace the silver ions and form a layer of silver on the surface of the copper. This reaction makes the copper more reactive. There are also other factors that affect the reactivity of metals, which includes the concentration and the types of the reactants, and even the temperature and pressure that affects the oxidation and the reduction in the process of chemical reactions. And also, when you were in grade 9, you've also learned that in chemical bonding, that atoms can gain stability if they lose or gain an electrons. We all know that in grade 9, you talk about the two types of bonding, the ionic bonding and the covalent bonding, and we also have the metallic bonding. Atoms strive to reach a state of maximum stability, which is often achieved when an atom's outermost shell is pulled. This is known as the octet rule, so dapat walo siya. That is the stable number of electrons that an element should possess. An octet rule, octet, octagon, which means eight. So atoms can lose or gain or share electron to fulfill this rule. So merong tatlo. Can lose, mababawasan ka. Gain, madadagdagan. O kaya makikipag-share ka para makomplete natin ang eight numbers of electrons. So let's take a look with this example of sodium and fluorine. Sodium with the symbol of Na and fluorine with the symbol of F. Sodium has a one electron in its outermost shell. One electron because it is also belongs to the family 1. As you can see on your periodic table, sodium is in a family 1, meaning to say they have one valence electrons on their outer shell. They are said to be a metal. It is easier for sodium to lose an electron than to gain 7 more. So, ibig sabihin, hindi siya yung tatanggap, kundi siya ang mag-transfer. Kasi mahirap naman nga sa kanya ang mag-gain ng 7 kaysa naman sa mag-lose ng isa. So, on this reason, so sodium tends to lose one electron, becoming a positively charged particle. Since nabawasan siya ng isang electron, ibig sabihin mas madami ang proton, kaya siya ay naging positive. For the fluorine side, which has a 7 electrons, yan ay nasa 7 family, in its outermost shell or the second shell, it also needs an 8 electrons. Okay, kailangan niya din ng 8 electrons. Kaso siya ay meron ng 7. So anong gagawin niya? Siya ba ay maglulose or mag-gain? Maglulose ba siya ng electron o magbabawas o magdadagdag siya ng electron? So it is easier for fluorine to gain 1 electron than to lose 7 electrons. So mas maganda sa kanya na siya ay makagain o tumanggap ng isang electron kaysa naman bawasan ang kanyang 7 electron. So, since ang sodium ay may isang electron, meaning to say, yung isang electron ay kailangan ng fluorine para ma-fulfill ang octet rule. So, meaning to say, the compatibility of sodium and fluorine is said to be very perfect. Yung isa kailangan mag-lose at yung isa naman kailangan mag-gain. Para saan? Para sa tinatawag nating octet rule. When sodium loses an electron, it's taken up by fluorine. This results in both atoms achieving in a stable electron configurations. So once the electron is transferred to fluorine, which is 7, 7 plus 1, you are now completing this what we call, or you are now obeying the octet rule. The resulting positive and negative ions attract each other, forming an ionic bond. Why it is called ionic bond? Because ionic bond means transferring of electron. It only happens between a metal and a non-metal. Sodium is metal, fluorine is non-metal. Usually, in the elements of the periodic table, most of the elements on the left sides are metals. That's why we have the alkali, and we also have the transition metals at the center. And mostly the non-metals, which includes gases, are found on the right side of the periodic table. So, meaning to say, all the elements on the family 1, which has 1 electrons, and all the elements which are non-metals on the 7th group, they are very compatible to each other. Wherein, they are losing 1 electron, the non-metals, they are gaining 1 electron from that family. This is an classic example of ionic bonding. Covalent bond is different from ionic bonding, because covalent bond exists only because they are sharing and they should exist between and elements that are considered non-metals. I hope I make myself clear. So these are the three topics that you've learned from grade 7, the acid and bases, from grade 8, the reactivity of metals, and for the grade 9, the types of bonding or chemical bonding. Now that you are in grade 10, we will dig more about the chemical reaction, wherein a chemical reaction is a part of one of the most important law in chemistry. If we have laws of motion in physics, we have this what we call law or batas sa tinatawag natin chemistry, which is the law of conservation of mass. Part 1. So, chemical reaction, law of conservation of mass, part 1. So, what is chemical reaction? You have learned that substances that undergo chemical bonding results in the breaking of bonds and formations of new bonds. So, meaning to say, may naghihiwalay at pagkahiwalay, may nabubuong panibago. So, in terms of chemical reactions, there is a formations of new substances. New substances are formed. In this example, on the left sides, the reactants are said to be the hydrogen and oxygen. So, hydrogen gas. If your teacher asks you to write what is the chemical formula for hydrogen, you're just going to write letter H, the symbol. But if the teacher told you to write what is the symbol for hydrogen gas, you're going to put number 2 since it is said to be a diatomic molecules. Okay? So, for example, the reactants, which is the hydrogen gas and oxygen gas, which is O2, react with another. They react with one another. They will form a new substance. A new substance which has this what we call H2O. So, nagcombine ang hydrogen and oxygen. Okay? So, from a single element, they now form a compound. So, are they compatible? Yes, they are compatible. Are they metal or non-metal? They are non-metal because hydrogen is a gas, oxygen is a gas. Okay? So, this formation of new substance means there is a chemical reaction taken place. So, meaning to say, the appearances or the characteristic of the individual element totally disappeared because new substance is formed out of those reactants. So we do have our products. So we can easily distinguish the reactants and the products because they are separated by the arrow. So keep in mind that the chemical reactions means there is a formation of new substances. Let's have a definition for a chemical reaction. A chemical reaction is a process that involves the rearrangement of the molecular or the ionic structure of a substance. This differs from a change in physical form or a nuclear reaction. Okay, because in terms of physical change, grade 7 pa din, you are not altering the identity, the original identity of a substance, but they are said to be still intact. For example, of a physical change, we have a paper, you just tear it. The keyword is tear. You cut it. You crumpled it. So, may pagbabago, but the composition of the paper is still the same. You just change the size. You just change the shape. Okay? So, but the composition of the paper is still the same. That is a physical change. But if you are altering, you are changing the whole identity of the substance, definitely it will undergo a chemical change or it undergo a chemical reaction process. It is a process wherein there are one or more substance transform into or more different substances. And during a chemical reaction, chemical bonds between atoms are broken and new bonds are formed, resulting in the creation of entirely new substances. So here we have an example of chemical reactions that are said to be consciously or unconsciously, product pala ito or example pala ito ng chemical reactions. We have the word combustion. So, ang ating symbol ay fire because combustion means burning. There is the presence of fire. Another one is a rust o pangangalawang, digestion. Okay? So, the foods that we eat. The photosynthesis that happens in the plants. We also have the fermentation for our wines and other liquors and beverages. Even in washing our hands and even clothes. And also, our favorite food or merienda, baking and even baking of breads or any other pastries. So, chemical reactions happens. Okay? And they are said to be observable. And now, it's your turn to give your own example of chemical reaction. So, pakilagay yan sa notebook. So, tumingin-tingin kayo sa bahay nyo. Tignan ninyo o magsulat kayo ng at least mga tatlong example of chemical reaction na napapansin nyo sa loob ng bahay. Okay? So, pakilagay yan. So, pag may sagot ka dyan, I will give you an additional points. Okay? I hope I make myself clear. Now, what are the indicators or the evidences of chemical reactions? Sir, madaling sabihin na may chemical reaction, pero ang tanong, ano-ano ang mga patunay o ebidensya that chemical reactions really takes place? Let us enumerate it one by one. The first evidence that chemical reaction takes place is the production of light o may liwanag. For example, if you place a strip of magnesium ribbon over a plane, this is the magnesium ribbon. It is burns with oxygen. An intense light will be formed. So when the magnesium react with the oxygen, the tendency is may makikita kang liwanag. And it is not only a light. An intense light was formed. Here's the chemical equation for this reaction is magnesium, which is solid, combined with oxygen gas, will produce magnesium oxide. Mg represents magnesium, O2 represents oxygen, the MgO represents the magnesium oxide. The reaction is highly exothermic, meaning to say it releases a large amount of energy in the form of heat and light, from the word exothermic, outside. So may matinding liwanag in the form of heat and light. This is why you see an intense white light when magnesium burns. This reaction is often demonstrated in chemistry classes. So as you watch different sci-fi movies and as they explore on their science laboratory, meron din tayo niyan, pero dahil nga sa pandemic, di tayo makakagawa. Okay? So, however, it is important to note that looking directly can harm your eyes because it is so bright. That's why when you are performing this kind of experiments, you should have your goggles because it can harm your eyes. Okay? It can hurt your eyes. So, the presence of light or the production of light indicates that there is a chemical reaction takes place. That would be the first evidence of chemical reaction. Now, the second evidence, aside from the production of light, is there is a change in intrinsic properties. Intrinsic, in, sa loob. Okay, what are those intrinsic properties? A change in intrinsic properties, like the color or odor, is another evidence that a chemical reaction happened. So, may pagbabagong naganap sa kulay at saka sa amoy niya. Okay? A change in intrinsic properties refers to a change in the inherent properties of a substance. What are those inherent? Inherent. Like the density, the melting point, the boiling point, or the specific heat capacity. A change in intrinsic properties can occur due to a physical or chemical change. If you will notice from our example from magnesium and oxygen, notice that after burning the magnesium ribbon, there is a change in color or even in its texture. A change in intrinsic properties such as color or odor is another evidence that chemical reaction has occurred. When a chemical reaction takes place, the reactants are transformed into new products with different chemical and physical properties. So, nababago ang kanyang itsura. Anong ebidensya? Dahil nabago ang kanyang itsura, nabago din ang kanyang kulay, okay? Nabago din ang kanyang amoy. Okay? So, merong, it can be a foul odor, but most of the time, iyan ay foul odor. Or medyo hindi maganda sa ating pang-amoy. So, another example, aside from magnesium and the oxygen, when the iron is exposed to air and moisture, kaya nagkakaroon tayo ng rusting. During rusting, iron reacts with oxygen and water to form an iron oxide, a new substance with different properties. So, nabago ang kulay ng metal from silver-gray. Ano nangyari pag nag-react ang oxygen? Di ba ito ay nagkukulay brown? So, a change of color is an indicator that a chemical reaction takes place. So, from gray to red or brown due to the formation of iron oxide, which is a different color than the original metal. Okay, ibang-iba sa ano ang kulay nung una siya. So, another example is a change in odor can also indicate that a chemical reaction has taken place. For example, when the food spoils, nababago ang amoy ng isang pagkain na napanis. So, bakit nababago ang amoy ng isang pagkain na panis? What causes? So, alam nyo ba kung anong cause nun? Okay. So, the cause of the spoilage because there is a presence of bacteria. the bacteria that cause the spoilage break down the organic compounds in the food, producing new compounds with different odors than the original foods. There is also a magkakaroon din yun ng amag. So, aside from bacteria, magkakaroon din siya ng presence ng fungi. Overall, a change in intrinsic properties such as color or odor can be a strong indicator that a chemical reaction has occurred. Okay, so nakakadalawa na tayo. Myelite sa intrinsic properties, particularly the color, the odor, and even the texture. Now, let's proceed with the third evidence. Another evidence is the evolution of gas. So, may gas na ma-observe. The evolution of gas is one of the evidence that a chemical reaction has occurred. When a chemical reaction takes place, new substances are formed, which is totally different from the physical and the chemical properties than the original substance. In some cases, this new substance, itong bagong substance na ito, ay nag-re-release ng gas. So, hindi lang pala liwanag, hindi lang pala nabago ang kulay at ibang pang-amoy. May makikita ka ding gas, which is also a byproduct of a chemical reaction na nangyari sa substance na yon. One of the example of evolution of gas is this, the vinegar and the baking soda, which is common na meron tayo sa bahay. So, for example, when you mix together the baking soda and a vinegar in a container, a chemical reaction happens. So, magkakaroon ng reaction yan. Sir, safe po ba? Yes, safe naman siya. Safe, but you should have a precautionary measures or seek the guidance of your parents bago kayo mag-experiment. Okay? An indicator that chemical reaction takes place is the presence of bubbles o may mga bula siya. Okay? So, pag pinagsama mo ang baking soda at vinegar, magkakaroon ng gas formation. Anong katunayan na may gas formation? Kasi may bula. Okay? May bubbles. Ano tong gas na yon? The evolved gas is carbon dioxide, which is a colorless and a heavy form of gas. To test the formation, o para malaman natin na ito ay carbon dioxide, to test the formation of carbon dioxide, it can be used to extinguish a lighted candle. Ayan. So the carbon dioxide displaces the oxygen which is needed to make the fire. Okay, so another evidence is the evolution of gas. Another, the fourth evidence, which is a change in temperature. So, a change in temperature means a chemical reaction happens. So, temperature, dalawa lang naman yan. High temperature and low temperature. Okay? So, going back to our example kanina sa ating baking soda and vinegar. When vinegar and baking soda were mixed, carbon dioxide evolved. An increase in temperature also happened during that reaction. So, as you can see in our illustration, the temperature of the substance that are mixed ay tumaas siya. So, this red bar indicates that there is a rising of temperature from lower temperature to higher temperature. So, ibig sabihin, mainit. So, kung hahawakan mo yung glass na yon na pinaglahaluan mo ng vinegar and baking soda, aside from the fact na may makikita kang gas, pag hinawakan mo yung glass yun, medyo mainit siya. Okay. Sir, walang change ng kulay. O, wala yon. Sir, walang light. Sir, hindi masyadong may amoy. Okay, pumunta tayo sa pangatlo. Yung gas formation. Pang-apat, temperature change. Still, kahit wala kang na-observe na una nating mga evidence, which is the light and the intrinsic properties, magpo-fall down tayo sa pangatlo at sa pang-apat. which is gas, and even the temperature change. So meaning to say, a temperature is a strong evidence that chemical reaction really takes place. Now, let's proceed with the last evidence of chemical reaction, which is the formation of precipitate. So, when a chemical reaction occurs, one strong evidence is the presence of precipitate. Sir, ano ang precipitate? A precipitate is a solid substance, so solid, that forms when two solutions react chemically and one of the products is insoluble in the solvent. From the word insoluble, hindi siya natunaw. Okay, we all know that the universal solvent is water. Okay, but not all liquids are said to be capable of dissolving substances, other substances. Kaya ang nangyayari, kapag nilagay mo dun siya, hindi siya natunaw o hindi siya nahalo or nagmix, or better use the word dissolve. Okay? So, meron tayong word na solute and solvent. So, yung hindi natunaw, ang tawag dun ay insoluble. Okay? This solid form as a result of chemical reactions and appear as a cloudy or solid material settling out of the solution. Settling out. Ibig sabihin, humihiwalay. Hihiwalay yung liquid sa solid. Okay? Hihiwalay ang liquid sa solid. So, a formation of precipitate indicates that a chemical reaction has taken place between two reactants. So, as you can see, we have here on the illustration, two aqueous medium. The result is meron tayong insoluble salt at nagkaroon tayo ng precipitate. So, as we have an example, if you combine an aqueous copper solution and a sodium hydroxide, it forms a blue precipitate. So, makakakita tayo ng blue precipitate pag pinag-combine natin itong dalawa. Okay, so ano pa yung mga basic example ng formation of precipitate na pwede natin makita sa bahay? For example, kung kayo ay may baby at ito ay nagtitimpla ng gatas ang inyong mother at nilalagay sa botelya at nakalimutang ipainom. So ang nangyari is, na-stuck yung gatas. Na-stuck yung gatas. After some time, binalikan mo na papainom mo pala sa baby. Nakita mo, yung gatas ay may parang buo-buo sa taas. Okay, iyon ay yung curdling of milk. So, nagkaroon ng, ang tawag doon ay precipitate. So, ibig sabihin, nagkaroon na ng chemical reaction. Pumaibabaw na siya. Nung buksan mo siya, iba na ang amoy. So, other change, intrinsic properties. Pwedeng, until such time, siguro pag matagal lang araw na nakastock siya, magbabago din ang kulay. So, those are some of the basic example na ay, may chemical reaction na takes place. Okay? So, those are the five basic evidences that chemical reaction takes place. Okay, unahin natin. Ano yun? So, we have here presence of light, change in intrinsic properties, the color and the odor, formation of gas, change in temperature, together with the formation of precipitate. Okay? I hope you learned those evidences of chemical reactions. Now, in terms of chemical reactions, we have two important terms that we need to remember. Gaya ng sinasabi ko kanina pa, yung word na reactants at yung word na products. Okay, so let's expound more what is the difference between reactants and products. So, keep in mind that chemical reactions occur when chemical bonds between atoms are formed or broken. Okay, so sa chemical reaction, may sinasabi ko kanina pa, pwedeng paghiwalayin, pwedeng pagcombinein. Okay, so may masisira at may mabubuo. Okay, so in terms of the bonding of the substances. The substance that go into a chemical reactions are called the reactants. Okay, so yung mga kailangan para magkaroon ng chemical reactions ay yung tinatawag nating reactants. Sila yung magre-react sa bawat isa. So kumbaga, kung gusto mong magkaroon ng isang pagkain sa pananghalian, halimbawa, ang pagkain mo ay sinigang. So, gusto mo magkaroon ng sinigang, anong gagawin mo? Bibili ka ng mga ingredients. Bibili ka ng isda or bibili ka ng karne. Bibili ka ng gulay at iba pang mga puta, iba pang mga ingredients. So, iyon ang tinatawag natin sa pagluluto na ingredients. In a context sa chemical reaction, ang tawag sa mga yon ay reactants. Okay? So, that is our keywords, the reactants. How about the products? The substance produced at the end of the reaction are known as the products. So, iyon ang tinatawag nating products. So, sa ating mga example, kadalasan, on the left side of our screen or on the left side of the chemical reaction, which is illustrated in a form of chemical equation, they are usually found on the left side. They are the reactants and they are separated by an arrow. At ang arrow na nasa kanan ay tinatawag nating product. So, sa konsepto ng halimbawa kanina, sa pagluluto ng isang sinigang. So, pagkatapos mong pagsamasamahin at intayin ng ilang minuto, ilang oras, kung oras man ang aantayin, meron ka ng kakaining pagkain, which is sinigang. At iyon yung product mo. Okay? Yung reactants, yung ingredients, at yung iniintay mong luto na kakainin mo sa pananghalian, yan ang tinatawag nating products. Malinaw ba yun? Okay, so I hope it is clear the difference between the reactants and the products. So for example, when a magnesium reacts with oxygen, ano dyan ang reactants at ano dyan ang products? Ito ba ay reactants or ito ba ay product? So since ito ay nasa left side of a chemical equation, so tandaan, a chemical reactions can be illustrated in a form of chemical equations. Paano yung chemical equation? A chemical equation is an illustrations of a chemical reactions. It can be in a form of word or it can be in a form of formula. Or, para mas madali nating maintindihan, naglalagay lang tayo ng mga pictures. Para, ano ba yung magnesium? Ay, ano ba itong oxygen? Okay? Para mas maayos tayo. So, magnesium and oxygen, definitely, ang tawag dyan ay reactants. Okay, so at ang sinasabi ko dito na ang magnesium oxide, which is on the right side, separated by an arrow, pagkalagpas ng ng arrow na yan, makakakita tayo ng product at nakakakita tayo ng magnesium oxides at ang tawag dyan ay products. So, reactants on the left, products on the right, but before you conclude that it is a product, it should be separated by a symbol which is an arrow. Okay? So, that is the difference between reactants and a products. So, this is an example of an illustrations of a chemical reactions in a form of chemical formula because mga symbols lang ang nakikita natin. So, the reaction involves the transfer of electrons from magnesium to oxygen, resulting in the formation of a new substance with different properties. Overall, the reactants and products in this reaction represents the starting material and final products of the chemical change. In the chemical equation for the reaction between magnesium and oxygen, to form magnesium oxide, meron tayong nakikita pang ibang mga parts or iba pang mga number. Okay, so makakakita tayo ng 2 on the right side, katabi siya ng magnesium. Okay, ang tawag dyan ay coefficients. Okay, at yung number na nasa ilalim, yung 2 na nasa ilalim ng oxygen, ang tawag naman dun ay subscript. Sub, from the word sub, sa ilalim. Okay, and meron din tayong arrow, okay, which means a reaction arrow. At itong mga S na nakalagay, which is enclosed by an open and closed parenthesis na may letter S, at meron ding letter G sa may O2 at may S sa Mg, which is magnesium, ang tawag dyan ay mga physical state or the phases of matter. Ano ba siya? Solid, liquid, gas. S for the solid, L for the liquid, G for the gas. Okay? So, what is the importance of those numbers and indicators? Overall, the coefficient and subscript help to balance the equations and indicate the number of atoms or molecules involved in the reactions. So, pag while the reactions are when physical states indicate the direction of the reactions in the physical states of the reactants and the products. Okay, so those numbers still obey this what we called the law of conservation of mass. Okay, wherein the number of atoms that is present in the reactants should be equal to the number of atoms right after the chemical reactions. Okay? So, it still obeys or follows the law of conservation of mass. So, this kind of topic will be discussed on the latter part or on the next lesson. Siguro nasa face-to-face na tayo nun. Okay? So, reactants are consumed in the chemical reactions to make products. So, the reactants and products in a chemical reactions can be written in a chemical equation. Yan ang tawag dyan, chemical equation. It is a written representation of a chemical reactions. Overall, chemical equations are an important tool for understanding chemical reaction and predicting the products will be formed. So, bago pa magkaroon ng makita natin yung pinaka-final product, if you know the reactants involved in a process, mapipredict mo na kaagad kung ano ang kalalabasan ng isang reactions. Okay, hindi tayo parang nanghuhula. So, halimbawa, pag pinagsama mo yung ganitong element sa ganitong element, ano kayang mangyayari? So, ang knowledge natin or understanding about the different elements ay napakalawak na. Since we are already 2024, we can already predict by means of a chemical equations, what would be the possible product of those substances that are combining to one another. So, this allow the chemist to communicate the details of reactions in a concise and standardized format. Now, in every chemical equations, we have different symbols used. So, before pa lang, na karoon na tayo ng forehand knowledge, what are those symbols? Now, let's start with the plus sign. The plus sign, which shows the combinations of reactants or products. Okay, so it separates the substances involved in the reactions. So, for example, O plus H or H plus O. So, sineseparate niya ang isang element or sineseparate niya ang isang compound to another combined na kailangan sa chemical reactions. What does it do? It helps to indicate that the substance involved in reactions and how they are combined or separated. Now, let's proceed with another symbol, which is an arrow. An arrow means to produce, to form, or to yield. Overall, the arrow is an important symbol in chemical equations that helps to indicate the direction of the reaction and the substances that are being transformed. The interpretation of the arrow as meaning to produce, to form, or to yield emphasizes the transformative nature of the chemical reactions. And this arrow separates the reactants from the products. The third symbol is the two arrows in opposite direction. What does it mean? Meaning, it is a reversible reaction. Reversible. Pwede siyang baliktarin. Overall, the reversible reaction is an important concept in chemistry, as many chemical reactions can proceed in either direction depending on the condition of the reactions. The use of the two arrows in opposite directions helps to indicate that the reaction is reversible and can proceed in either direction. So, pwede mo siyang baliktarin kapag may nakita ka na kapag yung elements ay pwede siyang ibalik into its original into its original states. Okay? So, halimbawa, yung salt, minix mo si water, pwede bang maibalik ulit yun? Makuha ulit yung salt? Pwede siya. Okay? So, reversible reactions. Now, how about an arrow with a triangle at the top? So, that triangle means delta symbol. It is a delta symbol which is placed above an arrow. Sir, pwede po ba sa baba? No. Taas nga eh. It indicates that the heat is applied to the reaction. May heat na in-apply. Okay, so nangangailangan ng init. But because not all substances requires heat. Kaya minsan sa ating reaction, walang delta symbol. So kumbaga sa example natin kanina sa pagluluto, paano ka magkakaroon ng sinigang kung may ingredients ka nga? So syempre, saan natin siya iluluto? Syempre, iluluto natin siya sa kalan. So, ang kalan may init, may apoy. So, the presence of heat is very important para magkaroon ng chemical reaction. Sir, applicable ba siya sa lahat? No. Hindi siya applicable sa lahat. Kaya nga, ito ay per characteristics or properties of the elements or compounds that undergoes a chemical reactions. Okay? This delta symbol. Okay? So, this kind of reactions is said to be exothermic, which releases heat. Okay, so exothermic means releasing of heat, or endothermic, which absorbs the heat. So ang keyword natin pag sinabing exothermic, exo labas, thermic heat, so release of heat, endothermic. Okay, endo means inside, absorbs heat, so ibig sabihin papasok ang init. So overall, the addition of the delta symbol above an arrow in a chemical equation is an important way to indicate the role of heat in a chemical reaction and can help predict the behavior of the reaction under different conditions. If a formula is written above or below the yield sign, it means a catalyst or a solvent was used in the reaction. Okay, kanina, heat is needed. Dito naman, maglalagay ka ng catalyst. So, what do we mean by a catalyst? Okay, a catalyst is any substance that is added to the reactants to speed up or slow down the process of chemical reaction. So, the keyword is it speeds up, pinabibilis, or pinababagal ang proseso ng chemical reaction. So, and usually they are written above or below the yield sign or the arrow sign. It indicates that the catalyst or solvent was used in the reactions. So the solvent in which a solute dissolves to form a solutions. These components are often written above without being consumed or altered in the process. So, ano-ano yung mga catalyst na yan? Sa halimbawa, kung ikaw isang magsasaka at gusto mo kaagad ibenta ang iyong product, halimbawa, ito ay mangga. Dahil matagal mahinog ang isang mangga, usually, hina-harvest sila. Ito ay binabalutan ng papel o dyaryo. Okay, isang process din yon para mapabilis. Pero kung ikaw ay nangangailangan pa at mas mabilis na paraan, naglalagay sila ng karburo. Okay? Naglalagay sila ng substance which is karburo. Nilalagay yun sa mangga. Para saan? Para mapabilis ang proseso ng pagpapahinog. Okay? Mapabilis ang proseso ng pagpapahinog. Iyon ay it speeds up the process of chemical reactions. Okay? Ano naman yung pagpapabagal or it slows down the process of chemical reactions. Halimbawa, kung ikaw ay magdadaing o gagawa ka ng tuyo sa isda, ang isda ay subjected sa pagkabulok. Paano hindi nabubulok ang isang isda? o isang isda na gagawing tuyo. Ito ay pinapaarawan. So sa pamamagitan ng pagpapaaraw, pwedeng maging dahilan ito para mapabagal ang proseso ng mapabagal ang proseso ng pagkabulok o chemical reactions. Ano pa? Kung ito ay lalagyan mo ng asin, so sodium chloride. A sodium chloride or asin ay pinapabagal niya ang decaying or decompositions of the fishes or foods. Kaya meron tayong proseso ng pagbuburo gamit ang asin. Okay? So it slows down the process of chemical reactions. Ganun siya. Okay? So that is the importance of a catalyst. Pwedeng pabilisin o pwedeng pabagalin. Okay. And the last would be the different symbols, just like what I've told you before. Symbols written beside the reactants and products as means solid, letter S. Make sure na ito ay nakalagay or ito ay enclosed with open and closed parenthesis. Bakit? Kasi ito ay may letter. Eh, ang element symbol ay letter din. And usually, this phases or states of matter are written in a small letter. Unlike with the symbol na malaking letter and then small letter, ito ay sinusulat sa maliliit na letter para hindi siya confusing. Okay? O magkaroon ng pagkalito pag ito ay nakalagay sa chemical equations. Okay? S for the solid, L for the liquid, G for a gas, and AQ means aqueous. So, aqueous meaning the substance is dissolved in water. Okay, ito ay tinunaw sa tubig. I do hope na you learn about the different symbols used in a process of chemical reactions. So, kung hindi man natatandaan, kindly return or have it on your notes na ibigay ko na yan sa inyo to review the different symbols that is present in a chemical equations represented by word equation or chemical formula equations. Okay, so as we continue, let's have an activity. Okay, ano kaya yung activity na yan? So let us perform an activity. Get a piece of paper and a pen. So yung paper ay sa notebook na lang. Okay. Have it on your notebook. Meron na ba? So, what are we going to do? You're going to identify the reactants and products in the following chemical reactions. Ako, napakadali. So, i-identify nyo lang kung ano doon ang reactants at ano doon ang products. Are you ready? Okay, let us start. So, syempre, proceed muna tayo sa ating direction. First, you're going to copy the following table on your paper. Complete it by writing the reactants and products from the given chemical reactions. So we have 5 examples. We have column for reactions, column for reactants, and column for the products. So our direction is identify the reactants and products from the chemical reactions below. Below each reaction, write the symbol or formula of the reactants and products. Okay, so ang gagawin, i-identify mo yung reactants at yung product. Ang una mo nang gagawin ay isulat yung word equation, then followed by formula equations. Okay, so nasa ibabaw yung word at nasa ilalim naman niya ang formula. Okay, so para hindi nakakalito, okay, mag-adjust na tayo. Let's have an example. Example na natin yung number 1. So, liquid hydrogen peroxide. Yan yung word. How about the symbol or the formula? H2O2. Hydrogen peroxide. In the presence of the catalyst manganese dioxide, produces water and oxygen gas. That is number 1. Number 2. Iron nails reacts with aqueous copper sulfate and form iron 2 sulfate and copper. Okay, before may nagtanong sa akin student yan, Rafael, hello. Bakit siya naging iron 2? Ang iron 2 ay may oxidation states na 2 and 3. Sir, may 1 kapag 1 hindi na isinusulat. Ang iron ay nasa transition metals. Usually, ang mga elements na nasa transition metals ay may mga Roman numeral, pero hindi lahat. So, pag may time pa, I will teach you about naming compounds, okay? So, especially yung mga may Roman numerals at itong mga peroxide, blah, 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 para meron na tayong forehand knowledge sa senior high. Okay, sana may time pa at mag-face-to-face na. Or else, alam nyo na. Okay, so let's have third, acetic acid or vinegar and sodium bicarbonate or baking soda produce sodium acetate with a release of carbon dioxide gas and water, which is H2O. So, andyan siya, ha? Let's have number 4. The fourth is a strip of magnesium ribbon combines with oxygen gas in the presence of heat to produce powdered magnesium. Magnesium is Mg, oxygen gas is O2, magnesium oxide is MgO. Yan, madali na, ha? May clue na yan sa reactants and products. Next, number 5. Lastly, in this activity, aqueous copper sulfate reacts with aqueous sodium hydroxide, NaOH, to produce insoluble copper 2 hydroxide, copper OH2, open and close parenthesis 2, and a sodium sulfate, Na2SO4, solution. Okay? That would be the problem 1 to number 5. Now, let's get ready. Let's check your answer. Okay? So, kung nalilito pa kayo, pwedeng balikan yung video. Okay? Pause and then copy. And then, pagka-copy nyo ng tanong, syempre, susulat nyo yan. Hindi yan answer only. Copy and answer. Okay? So, let's check your answer. So, for the first chemical reaction, so, ibibigyan na natin yung sagot. So, sa una, liquid hydrogen peroxide, H2O2. So, ang unang ilalagay ay yung pangalan, yung word, equation. Hydrogen peroxide or peroxide. Ang kanyang formula is H2O2. In the presence of the catalyst manganese dioxide, which is MnO2. Okay, ang tanong, ilalagay ba to? Porkit may nakita kang symbol na MnO2 na compound na cat. Ano? Ang tinutukoy natin ay reactants at products. May catalyst ba? O wala. So, hindi natin papakailaman yan kahit may symbol pa yan. Okay? So, kasi ang hinahanap lang natin ay reactants at saka products. Okay? So, ang reactants natin ay hydrogen peroxide and this what we call product. Ano kaya ang product? So, ang product ay ang water and oxygen. The products are water and oxygen. What is the symbol for water? H2O. How about the oxygen? O2. Okay. So, yon ang reactants at ito naman ang products. So, given ko na ang number 1. So, mas madali na para sa inyo ang number 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. So, ilalagay pa rin yung sa table, ha? Para mas madali sa inyo, para hindi na kayo mag-backward. Ito na. Ito yung natitirang apat. It is now your turn to respond to questions 2 through 5. Please record your answer in your notebook as your assigned task because the title of your activity is Reactants versus Products. In chemical reactions, it can be written in chemical equations, just like what I told you before. Okay, for us to easily understand the concept of chemical reactions, dapat siya ay naka-illustrate sa chemical equations. At ang chemical equations are divided sa dalawang pamamaraan. Ang pinakamadali ay ang word equation na nakasulat ang mga pangalan, at yung pangalawa naman ay ang chemical formula na may mga symbols at may mga letters tayong ginagamit. Okay? So, using some symbols, since the reactants and products are written in chemical, okay, formulas. We can write the chemical reactions in chemical equations. So these chemical formulas are the building blocks of understanding the composition and the behavior of different substances. They provide a concise representation of the elements present in a compound and the ratio in which they combine. While they may seem like a jumble of symbols and numbers to the untrained eye, chemical formulas hold a wealth of information waiting to be unlocked. Ano-ano ba ito? Okay, so sabi nga, nakakahilo na, nakakalito na yun. May mga letters, may mga numbers. Since tayo ay na-acquaint na sa mga letters sa periodic table, huwag na tayong matakot. Hello, grade 10. Okay, so let us enrich ourselves para may kunting kaalaman tayo sa iba. Okay, what are those basic chemical formula? The first one is empirical formula. It provides the simplest whole number ratio of elements in a compound. Okay? And usually, they are in a form of Lowe's term, while the molecular formulas gives the exact number of each element present in a molecule. Kaya meron tayong C4H10. Tapos yung empirical formula niya is C2H5. So, kung makikita mo, ito ay odd. Itong ating carbon 2, tas hydrogen is 5. Ang carbon dito sa molecular is 4, ito ay 10. So, ang pinakasimple, ano dito, ito ang pinakatunay. Ito ang lowest term. Ano ba? 4 and 10, they are both even numbers. Saan sila divisible? Divisible sila sa 2. Okay, kasi sila even number. So, for example, 4 divide 2, 2. Ito na yon. 10 divide 2, 5. Iyon na yon. Okay? So, how about the condensed and the, this is what we call the structural formula. A condensed formula is an order and a formula of a functional groups. So, familiar na kayo sa ganito. Ito ay ilan sa mga formula ng ating mga biomolecules. Remember, the carbohydrates, the lipids, and the proteins. The carbonyl, carboxyl, alam nyo na. Okay, how about the structural formula? The structural formula is a graphic representations of structure of the condensed formula. So, ito halimbawa, CH3. C1, 2, 3, CH3. Tatlo yun. Ito yung una, CH3. Okay, tingnan natin. Ito, C, yung itong 3 na to. 1, 2, 3. CH3. Pangalawa. Ito, pangalawa na. Yan, nanginginig pa kamay ko. C. Ilang hydrogen? 1, 2. CH2. So on and so forth. Okay, tapos pag ginawa mo siyang skeleton, naka-skeleton, ang tawag doon ay structural formula. Okay? So, I hope I made myself clear. Yan. Now, let's get ready. Let's have another activity. After identifying the products and the reactants, let's have our another activity. You're going to write the chemical reactions in chemical equations, just like what we have in our example. You may pause this video as you write your answer. Using the formula and symbols, here are the chemical equations of the 5 chemical reactions. Okay? So, ito ay example ng chemical equations. Okay, ang una, by picture, picture representations of chemical reaction. Tapos, may nakita kayong word. Ang tawag dyan ay word equation. Kasi, tire-translate sa word. At yung pangalawa naman ay by means of formula. Kasi, gumamit na tayo ng symbol. Halimbawa, oxygen. Oxygen present siya sa cloud, sa air. Yan. Tapos, nail. A nail is made up of iron. H2O, water droplets. We have the arrow and then the rust. Yung pagbabago ng kulay. Yan. Oxygen is written as oxygen gas, O2, plus iron. Iron is Fe. Sir, ba't walang 2? Kasi ang iron ay metal. Naglalagay lang ta ng 2 diatomic molecules sa gas o non-metals. Okay? Sana malinaw yon. Ang mga metal, hindi nila lagyan ng 2 sa ilalim. Okay? Kung may nakita kayo sa iron na 2, Roman numeral yon, diatomic molecules. Pag 1 kasi, hindi na nilalagay. Pag dalawa, ibig sabihin, nilagay tayo Roman numerals. Okay? At ito ay naka-open and close parenthesis. Plus, plus water, H2O, yan. And then, it gives or yields to Fe2O3H2O. Okay, iron oxide water. Iron, oxygen, hydrogen, oxygen. Okay, but there is a proper name for that. Okay, so that would be. Siyempre, ang pinaka-equation yan, ito yung tawag dyan ay rusting. O, kalawang. Okay, so ano-ano na? Sana yung mga problem, sir? Sana yung problem, sir? Okay, so ang una natin, ito ay, you're going to write the chemical reactions in a chemical equations. Ayan, isusulat natin, ita-translate sa katulad ng ginawa natin kanina. So, una, liquid hydrogen peroxide. Ito yung example natin kanina. In the presence of the catalyst manganese dioxide, catalyst, produces water and oxygen gas. Okay, so hydrogen peroxide, o H2O2, ano siya? Liquid. Open and close, liquid. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. So, sulat muna natin yung symbol, H2O2, ano siya? Liquid, open and close. Pero pag walang naman nakalagay na liquid, automatic, huwag muna lagyan ng open and close parenthesis na L. Diretso tayo sa H2O2. Okay, in the presence of the catalyst manganese. So, ang catalyst, manganese. So, maglalagay muna tayo ng arrow. Okay, arrow. Saan nilalagay yung catalyst? Sa taas o baba? Pwedeng sa taas, pwedeng sa baba. Okay? Produces water. Produces. So, ito yung produces, yung arrow. Water. Isusulat na natin water at saka oxygen. Water and oxygen. So, magkahiwalay. And, yung end na yan, yun yung, ang gagamitin yung symbol dyan ay plus. Okay? O, yan ha. Ito yung manganese dioxide. Pwedeng sa ilalim, pwedeng sa baba. So, ibig sabihin yan ay catalyst. So, hydrogen oxide, dihydrogen oxide, or tinatawag natin water, dihydrogen kasi dalawa, oxide isa. Hydrogen, water, liquid yon. And, yung end, sinasabi ko sa inyo. And, yan o, end, oxygen yan, oxygen. Itong end na yan o, ang end ay plus, magkahiwalay, water and oxygen gas. Sir, dito sa ila, kabila, sa mga example mo, laging may plus. Okay. Depende kasi yan sa word equation. Kasi ito word equation. Susundan lang natin. Pag walang nakalagay na oxygen and hydrogen or hydrogen and oxygen, pag may nakita kang and hydrogen combine or hydrogen react with oxygen, automatic yung sa reactants, may plus yun. May plus siya, separated by plus. Eh kaso ito, isang buo. Liquid hydrogen peroxide. Okay, just remove the letter D. Peroxide yan. Hindi peroxided. Okay, H2O2 in the presence of the catalyst manganese produces water and oxygen gas. So, ita-translate natin itong word equation into formula equations. Malinaw ba? Ilalapat lang natin. Okay, so be careful kung anong symbol, especially kung anong state of matter, at ano yung catalyst, ano yung mga ano, presence sa reactants, at ano ang presence sa products. Okay? I hope I make myself clear. Malino ba yun? Nakakasunod ba? Okay? Yan. So, another one is iron nails reacts with aqueous copper sulfate, CuSO4, okay, copper, hindi yan CO, forms iron 2, iron, ito yon. Ano ang iron? Solid. Reacts, yung reacts means plus. With aqueous copper sulfate, copper, kopihin na itong symbol na yan. Ito yun, copper sulfate. Ano daw ang copper sulfate? Aqueous, so maglagay tayo ng AQ. Okay? And forms iron 2. Iron 2. Ano yung iron 2? So, Fe2. Forms iron 2. So, nag-forms iron 2. Ibig sabihin, pa-product na yon. Forms iron 2 sulfate. Okay. Iron 2 sulfate. FeSO4. Sir, nasaan yung 2? Iron 2. Okay. Ang hirap kasi dito mag-example. Sa iron 2 na yan, kung titignan mo kasi, pag isosolve mo yan, isosolve mo siya, bali ang mangyayari, Fe2, hirap, okay, so I will explain it na lang sa ano, I will explain it na lang sa live, medyo tricky dito sa pagsusulat, okay, sa laptop, okay, don't worry, I will explain it, bakit nawala yung 2, but FeSO4 na lang, and copper, and, so ibig sabihin plus yan, and copper, Cu, okay, so, malaman natin bakit nawala yung 2 na yan. Okay? Don't worry. I will explain it. That is number 2. Let's have number 3. Acetic acid. Copy the symbol. Okay? Liquid siya. And sodium bicarbonate. Solid siya. Baking soda. Produce sodium acetate. Produce. So, produce RO. Okay? Okay? With the release of carbon dioxide. Copy the sodium acetate. Copy the sodium acetate. And then the release of carbon dioxide gas and water liquid. Okay? So, yan lang. Ganyan lang siyang gagawin. Next. Number 4, magnesium combines with oxygen gas, O2, with the presence of heat. So, may delta symbol with the presence of heat to produce powdered magnesium oxide. So, ang powdered ay liquid. Sorry. Gas. Solid. Ano ba yan? Sorry. Solid. Okay, stand corrected. And the last, aqueous copper sulfate reacts with aqueous sodium hydroxide to produce insoluble copper 2 hydroxide, COUOH2, and copper sulfate solution. Okay, copper sulfate solution. Okay, so yan. So, our copper sulfate solution. So, those are some of the examples of our activity. Sample lang yun para bigay malito. Okay? So, ngayon naman, let's have our another activity. Okay, write the chemical reactions in chemical equations. You may pause this video as you write your answer. Using the formula and symbols, here are the chemical equations of the 5 chemical reactions. So, iba. So, ang gagawin nyo, katulad kanina, pero iba naman example ang ibibigay ko sa inyo. Okay? Sensor, ilalagay sa notebook pa din, yung kadugtong nung una nating activity 1. So, chemical equations in the form of chemical formula. Okay. So, these are the following. Converting word equations to chemical formula. Ang una natin example ay combustion of methane. Write the chemical formula for combustion of methane in oxygen to produce carbon dioxide and water. Okay? Photosynthesis. Express the photosynthesis where carbon dioxide and water form glucose and oxygen in the presence of sunlight as a chemical formula. Okay? Acid-base reaction, hydrochloric acid reacts with sodium hydroxide to produce sodium chloride and water. Represent this reaction with chemical formula. Next is the precipitation reaction. Okay, and the synthesis of water. Okay, so you're just going to read it and have it on a formula. And the other problems, ibibigay ko na lang sa inyo sa live. Okay, 5 na lang. Baka kasi, ano na, napakadami na. Okay? So, 5 lang para mas madali nating masagutan. Okay? Yan. Do you have any questions? Violent reactions. Okay. Now, let's end our discussion. Okay? After knowing the chemical reactions as part of the law of conservation of mass, we also determine the evidences of chemical reactions, how to represent chemical reaction in forms of chemical equations into a word equations and even in a chemical formula equations. And we also identify the different symbols used in a chemical reactions and even we identify the reactants and the products. Medyo yung the other topics, mas gusto ko siyang i-discuss sa live kasi medyo tricky at medyo ang daming kinakopy. Eh, medyo matatas sa pagsusulat. Ano yun, hindi ako magaling sa ano yun na yan. Dito sa pagsusulat. Okay, dyan sa screen. Okay, that's why, sana pag nag-face to face. Okay, so let's end this discussion with a simple quote coming from one of my favorite anime, which is Tokyo Ghoul. It says that human relationships are chemical reactions. If you have reaction, then you can never return back to your previous state of beings. Remember, this quote means that human relationships are like chemical reactions, in that once they happen, they can have a permanent effect on us. Just like how chemical reaction can change the properties of the substance, says, relationship with others can change who we are as people. Siyempre, kapag nakakasalamuha tayo ng ibang tao, nababago din tayo. Totally different kapag ikaw ay mag-isa, at totally different kapag ikaw ay may kasama. As students who are relationships with others can change who we are as people. And as students who are graduating as a junior high school students, this quote can remind you that the relationship you have formed during your school years may have a profound impact on your future. So cherish the moments. May mga chemical reaction pala dyan. The connections you have made with your classmates, teachers, and other individuals will shape your experiences and memories of your school years. As you move on to high school or senior high school, or yung iba man ay mag-stop muna para makapagtrabaho at makatulong sa pamilya, o yung iba ay kung pinalad at may pagkakataon, mag-aral sa susunod na antas, which is senior high, it's important to remember the role that this relationship have played in your life. Patuloy nyo siyang aalalahanin at kapupulutan ng aral kung ano man inyong mga natutunan, lalo na nagkaroon tayo ng face-to-face class. And to be mindful of the relationship you form going forward. Additionally, this quote can serve as a reminder that our relationships are not just transactions. Kaya nakapag-form tayo ng bond or friendships. Nakausap mo, naging kasama mo sa grupo, ng presentations, gaya ng nangyari sa akin. They are chemical reactions that can have a lasting impact on our lives. Sometimes, bumabalik tayo sa pinaka-core natin. Yung mga tinatawag nating high school friends. It's important to be intentional and thoughtful in our interactions with others and to approach our relationships with empathy, openness, and a sense of responsibility. So ito yung mga ingredients for strengthening our friendships or bond na nabuo hindi lang sa kaibigan mo, kaya sa classmate mo. Pag casual, yes, be civil, pero iba yung treatment pag nagkaroon kayo ng formations as a friendship. So as you move on from junior high school, remember that the relationship you form as you continue your education and enter the adulthood will continue to shape who you are and what you become. Kung iba ka man ngayon sa kung anuman ikaw noon, sana may positive change. Change for the better, not for the worse. And those changes still fall under a chemical reactions. I hope may natutunan tayo. And be mindful that every moment and bond na meron tayo sa isa't isa ay pinapahalagan at chine-cherish. At nawa may naintindihan kayo at may natutunan ngayong araw sa ating discussions about chemical reactions. I hope you learned and enjoyed our lesson. This is your Sir Daryl Villorente. See you in the next lesson. Sana face-to-face na, dahil medyo mahirap talaga gumawa. As we come to the end of this instructional video for Grade 10 learners, I trust that you have gained knowledge and found pleasure in learning about chemical reactions, recognizing their indications, distinguishing the products and reactants, and transforming word equations into chemical formula equations, and how chemical reactions also happens to us in real life. And I anticipate your attendance in the upcoming lesson. I am your Sir Daryl Villorente. signing off for today. Happy learning! Thank you very much.